Hey, what's going on? It's Doug Cunnington here from Niche Site Project, and in this video, I'm going to tell you about The Hoth. The Hoth is a link building agency. Actually, they're a full suite of products. I think they do content and some other stuff, but I know their roots are in link building, and that's mainly the products that I've used from The Hoth. Now, I've worked with The Hoth for years, and I'm an affiliate for them, so I get a commission if you buy anything through my link. But I'm a user of their services, and you know they have great customer service and I've had great results. In fact, I've been using them along with another company for my age site case study. And prior to the case study, I tested out the service to make sure it was good and I was seeing the results that I wanted to see. So with that said, the services that I used from The Hoth in the past were more like gray hat type services and products. In this case, at this point, I don't do any sort of gray hat stuff, but it's more white hat. The services that I've used are white hat services. So it's like guest posting and the syndication product. I don't have as much experience with a syndication product because it's brand new, but I've been testing it and I've been getting pretty good results. That'll be a future video. So at this point, I want to let you know the key thing that you should understand when you're using The Hoth for the guest posting service. So the big thing is you need to pick your package, right? Based on, that's a weird phrase, I should probably say that differently, but you need to select your product and the service that you want based on the organic traffic of the site that you're gonna put the guest post on, or they will do it, right? It's a full white glove service situation. But basically in the past, we would buy or sell guest posts based on the domain authority of the site. All right, so generally that is a Moz metric, by the way. The problem with the DA or the PA or any of those metrics for a domain rating, you can manipulate those based on links that you're sending to them. So the big problem is it's a metric from some company, right? Moz or Ahrefs or Majestic or whoever, right? It's a metric based on however they gather that data. And you can manipulate that metric. Whatever metric you're thinking you want to use, you can manipulate it. Now, the cool thing with The Hoth and the guest posting packages now is you can use organic traffic as the criteria. And that means, in my opinion, that Google likes the site, all right? Google likes the site if they are sending organic traffic to that site. So you can select based on, different, organic traffic ranges. So I can't remember off the top of my head. It may be 1,000, 5,000, 10,000, 50,000, something like that. And it's more expensive, the more traffic a site gets. But in my opinion, that sort of vets the site. You can't manipulate that, right? So if you can go check in a tool and see that a particular site is indeed getting organic traffic from Google, then you know it's good to go. So I've been using that criteria for my guest posting packages, and it's been fantastic. I've been seeing really high metrics and really good relevancy in all cases.
Before we go to the Search Console data, let's have a look at the overall traffic. This is the weekly traffic, and you can see it's consistently moving up. There's no hockey stick growth or anything like that, but it's continuing to move up, and that is great. That's exactly what I'm looking for. Here are some of the results traffic-wise. Obviously, getting the backlinks is great. You want to move up in the rankings in general. And then, of course, the real goal is to get traffic to your site and then make sales. As you can see, I've taken a bit of a snapshot here from when we got the links on the site. And by the way, I'm talking about links coming from both The Hoth, guest posting, and Loganics as well, and from blog commenting. So keep that in mind. There's links coming from various sources, but I'm confident in these sources. So let's also take a look at what we have going on the Search Console so you can see just the impact of when the links hit. So we're looking at the Search Console here and going back to when I got the site. But basically, you can see, if this little thing will get out of the way here, you can see generally in the same way. Clicks are going up and total impressions are going up as well. So we could see here clicks are going up. There's not a way to sort of smooth out the graph here, but the overall trend is moving up. And you can see it's sort of like hitting new highs each week. So that's great. We could look at the impressions, of course, and get sort of an idea of like where things are showing up. That's also moving up. So that's fantastic. That is obviously what we're looking for. The average position here you can see is also improving. And I think this sort of tells the full story, right? So when you look at the average position, it is improving, right? So previously it was down here and it looks like, you know, at some point, maybe some, I'm not sure what the deal was right when I got the site, but maybe a few of the positions went down as I was adding more content, adding backlinks, stuff like that. Sometimes weird things happen when you're doing SEO work. And typically, if you're just doing normal things like I'm doing, then it will recover and probably get better. So you can see it's just sort of ticking up a little bit here and there, dancing around just a bit. One thing to note is like, you know, I add a lot of content on the site. And when you add more content on the site, the total number of impressions will likely go up, especially if you're using keyword golden ratio type content. And then for that reason, a lot of times you'll show up for more impressions. However, your overall position may go lower. And in this case, it seems to be staying fairly stable or at least moving up a little bit. So this is good from my perspective. And it's kind of the, you know, the trend is going up. That's what we want to see. I want to show you what I'm talking about as far as ordering on the Hoth. So this is the sales page. So if you hopped over here, you can read all about it. You know, they'll tell you a little bit more about it. But the big thing is here, the criteria of where your guest post will go. So previously, all you could do in the past was select by domain authority, which is antiquated. And I would say in a lot of ways, just not all that accurate. And the big thing is you can manipulate that metric. However, publisher traffic, they say guaranteed monthly organic traffic level of the publishing site. You can verify that independently. You can see that on your own with independent tools. And if they're getting organic traffic from Google, you can assume that Google probably likes them a little bit. So you should be choosing publisher traffic here, all right? Publisher traffic, that is the criteria that you want to select. As far as, you know, which level you want here, it obviously gets more expensive if you get more traffic. But basically, the more you spend, the better the site will be. So whatever your budget is, figure out your budget, figure out how you need to align it. Questions may be out there like, should I get, you know, 5 links on a 1,000, or I don't know what the cost is exactly, but should you get, you know, 2 links from one of the lower packages or 1 link from one of the higher packages? I can't answer that for you. I think you could probably find examples for both cases where, you know, 2 links from smaller sites is better, or 1 link from a big site is better. So there's no like set formula where it's like, it's always better to do X or Y. So I have no idea. And I mean, I think it just depends on the site and your site and the keywords that you're going for and all that kind of stuff. So this is how you pick it. And you can, you know, obviously go nuts over here. You could spend $40,000 on backlinks if you wanted to. That's 100 posts, but I mean, that'd be insane. Anyway, this is how you do it. I'm an affiliate for the Hoth, as you know. So if you do purchase through my link, I really do appreciate it. I get a commission and I'll probably buy a beer or two or something like that. And I can tell you the customer service at the Hoth is fantastic. They deliver on time. Like, it's very process oriented. It's a very, very tight team out there.
If you are thinking about using the Hoth, you should probably, definitely, all right, you should definitely use the organic traffic criteria, not the domain authority. If you have some other special goal with your package or what guest post you want or something like that, sure, maybe you use the DA, but in most cases, like I would say 99 to 100% of the time, you should be using the organic search traffic metric to select your guest posting package. And I've been super impressed with the sites that my links have been showing up on. So if you have any questions about like the Hoth service, guest posting, or whatever, please leave a comment below. And if it's your first time on the channel, thanks for watching. Have a look at some of the other videos. I talk about affiliate marketing, SEO, keyword research, stuff like that, some random stuff as well. And if you like what you see, please subscribe.